The Rapture Confusion Debunked. After watching this video, you should be head cleared from any confusion you have as to whether the rapture is a false teaching or a sound teaching, or as to whether the rapture is pre-tribulation, pre-wrath, or post-tribulation. If you are still in rebellion after this video, then you'll need to question your faith. What are the three causes of the rapture confusion? 1. People tend to rely on the preaching of pastors or someone to form a conclusion on the theology, instead of reading the Bible and allowing the Bible to interpret itself. The second cause is pride. Most people believe what they think, or what they are indoctrinated with from childhood, or from the prelim stages of their Christian life, is the only doctrine or view that has to be right irrespective of biblical evidence and scriptures given to them. They tend to pick and choose what seems right in their eye with their own falsified doctrines that rebel against truth. And the third cause of this confusion is mere ignorance. Some people don't even have biblical evidence of what they believe in, so they easily get tossed around by preachers and false prophets throughout their Christian lives. Before you continue watching this video, open your heart and humble yourself to the scriptures I am going to give you. And when you are done, go and open your Bible and read it to verify and reconcile this message. We will start by proving if the rapture is biblical or not biblical. Before I start, whenever or wherever you hear or see the word rapture, it simply means the resurrection of those who are dead in Christ and the catching up of believers who are still alive at the time of resurrection. So write this down. Rapture means the resurrection of the dead. Rapture means catching up of those who are alive at the resurrection when Jesus comes down in the clouds to receive us unto himself. It is generally called the rapture because this resurrection involves those who are still alive. If not so, it will just be called the resurrection, which means raising from the dead. If you are still in rebellion, click away immediately. If you are humble and willing to learn, let's continue. The only book in the Bible that explains the resurrection in detail is the book of Corinthians. Turn your Bible to 1 Corinthians 15. We are going to study and interpret as we read through.
Paul says, and I read, "Now, brothers and sisters, I want to remind you of the gospel I preached to you, which you received and on which you have taken your stand. By this gospel you are saved, if you hold firmly to the word I preached to you. Otherwise, you have believed in vain."
What gospel is Paul talking of? The gospel of salvation. Let's continue.
Verse 3, "For what I received, I passed on to you, as of first importance that Christ died for our sins, according to the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day, according to the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, and then to the 12.
In verse 3 to 4, we see Paul giving us the gospel of our salvation. Let's continue.
Verse 6, "After that, he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers and sisters at the same time, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles, and last of all he appeared to me also, as to one abnormally born."
Note that this is the evidence of Jesus' resurrection. We see Jesus appearing to these groups of people to witness his resurrection, proving that he was indeed raised from the dead after his crucifixion. From verse 9 to 11, Paul proceeds to talk of his salvation and his calling from God to preach, which I'm going to skip it, because some of you are getting impatient and some have already clicked off. Verse 12. "But if it is preached that Christ has been raised from the dead, how can some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? If there is no resurrection of the dead, then not even Christ has been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, our preaching is useless, and so is your faith." Here we can see the same group of people in our time who say there is no rapture. Remember, I said rapture means resurrection of the dead and catching up of believers who are still alive at the time of resurrection. In verses 12 to 14, Paul refutes those who say there is no rapture and tells them that they are denying that Christ did not resurrect. If Christ did not resurrect and there's no rapture, meaning you following Christ in the first place is useless and your faith is valueless. Let's continue.
Verse 15, "More than that, we are then found to be false witnesses about God. For we have testified about God that he raised Christ from the dead. But if he did not raise him, then it means the dead are not raised."
So there you go. If at this stage you still don't believe there's a rapture, then I don't know the God and Jesus you serve. You better click off before I add the spices to the meat. Gospel is not even done yet.
Verses 16. For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised either. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile, you are still in your sins. Then those also who have fallen asleep in Christ are lost. If only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied.
You just heard what Paul said. He said your faith is futile and you are still in your sins if you don't believe there's a rapture. He couldn't have said any better. Now before we move on to the next verse, we can confidently affirm that the no rapture doctrine is a false doctrine and it's not a doctrine from God but of man. We can continue to say the no rapture doctrine disproves that Jesus resurrected from the dead, and whoever propagates such doctrine is a false teacher, and whoever believes such doctrine is an unbeliever and is better off not being a follower of Christ, not by my own words but of God. When is the rapture? Well, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, 20-24 details the sequence of the rapture and resurrection.
1 Corinthians 15, verse 20. But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead comes also through a man. For as in Adam all die, so in Christ all will be made alive.
Now before we proceed, I would like you to pay attention to verse 23 well. Verse 23, but each in turn. Christ, the first fruits. Then, when he comes, those who belong to him. 24, then the end will come when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father after he has destroyed all dominion, authority, and power. The order of the resurrection, aka rapture, raptero, or harpazo, is clearly stated in verse 23. Verse 23, but each in turn. Christ, the first fruits. Then, when he comes, those who belong to him. Keyword, but each. Each what? Each in turn. Number 1. Christ. Number 2. The first fruits, and number 3. When he comes 1. Christ has already resurrected 2. The first fruits. Who are the first fruits Paul is referring to? Romans 8 verse 22-23. We know that the whole creation has been groaned in as in the pains of childbirth right up to the present time. Verse 23. Not only so, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit grown inwardly as we wait eagerly for our adoption as sons, the redemption of our bodies. In verse 22 we see Paul addressing the Old Testament saints, and the church in verse 23. And the third key word from the 1 Corinthians 15, 23 verse states when he comes, those who belong to him. This is referring to the tribulation saints who will be gathered at the four corners of the earth by his angels to meet us with Christ. This completes the first resurrection, and after that God destroys the earth with the bowls and trumpets. Here, post-trib believers, saints should note that there's no trumpet sound before they are taken. Most of post-trib say the last trump is the fifth seal, but even at the opening of the seals we don't see trumpet in those verses. The only trumpet that's about to sound from now on is the last trumpet call of God, and it'll be at the soon coming rapture event. From this, we can conclude that the pre-tribulation rapture is the only rapture since people will still be alive to participate in the resurrection. But at the post-tribulation resurrection, all saints will be resurrected. Since they were all killed, none of them will be alive to be raptured. This can be backed by Revelation 6, 9. When he opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of those who had been slain because of the word of God and the testimony they had maintained. They called out in a loud voice, "How long, Sovereign Lord, holy and true, until you judge the inhabitants of the earth and avenge our blood?" Then each of them was given a white robe, and they were told to wait a little longer, until the full number of their fellow servants, their brothers, and sisters were killed just as they had been. Now the truth has been presented to you since you refused to read your Bible. Thank you for listening through to the end. I will encourage you to spend time studying the Bible for yourself. Rapture Confusion Debunked. Like this video to enable the algorithm to recommend this video to the unsaved, lost, and uncertain. and share this video to comfort your loved ones and to edify the body of Christ, and most importantly, share it to your friends who believe there's no rapture at all. The rapture of the church is soon. Stay ready at all times and get to know your Bible for yourselves. May the Lord count us worthy on His return.
What if His appearance occurs on a Sunday morning? My prophetic word to you this morning is get ready! Get ready!